Well, good morning, MPC, and Merry Christmas. We're glad that you could join us for worship this morning. This morning, we're just going to listen to some music, some scriptures, some prayers, and a short message to celebrate that Jesus is here.
Thank you.
Let's pray together. Jesus, thank you for revealing yourself to us by your holy incarnation, by your human birth, by your pure and blameless childhood, by your obedience and diligence, by your humility, meekness, and patience, by your extreme poverty, by your griefs and sorrows, by your prayers and tears, by your having been despised and rejected, by your cross and your suffering, by your death and burial, by your triumphant resurrection and ascension. Thank you for revealing yourself to us today and every day. Amen. Our scripture today is one that we also read last night, and it's from Luke chapter 2. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and all went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. And while they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place in the guest room. That scripture is not only amazing because it talks about Jesus being born, but it's also a little scary, isn't it? That Mary and her husband were faced with not finding any room in a guest inn, and that she had to lay her baby in a manger after it was born because there was no room for them. And it doesn't talk about a stable. We just assume because there was a manger that it was some kind of place that animals were held. But we think about that, and I wonder who missed out on getting to be a part of Jesus's birth because they weren't there. Who missed out on getting to see Emmanuel, God with us, in person because they couldn't make any room? And how often do we forget to make room for Jesus? I mean, think about it. God is with us. Do we let that touch every part of our lives? Do we remember that when our lives are filled with anxiety and worry? Do we remember that when our lives are filled with joy and celebration? Do we remember that God is with us for all of it? There's a poem by Madeline L'Engle called In the Darkest Hour that I want to share with you. It was a time like this, war and tumult of war, a horror in the air, hungry yawned the abyss, and yet there came the star, and the child most wonderfully there. It was time like this, of fear and lust for power, license and greed and blight, and yet the Prince of Bliss came into the darkest hour in quiet and silent night. And in a time like this, how celebrate his birth when all things fall apart? Ah, wonderful it is, with no room on the earth, the stable is our heart. Can you make room for that kind of love, no matter what chaos awaits you today or in the weeks to come? Can you accept the kind of love that enters into the darkest and the worst places and brings love and light? Where do you need to make room for that today? What worries or fears are you carrying that need the peace that Isaiah prophesied the Messiah would bring? Is there a loneliness or a grief that is clouding your celebration today that could use the love of a Savior? Because it's here for you. As we talked about last night in Christmas Eve, God's love is here. It's here. The God of the universe was willing to be wrapped in vulnerability and humility and love. He came in its weakest form, in our weakest form. I mean, think about it. Human babies are the only ones that can't walk within hours or a few months. And yet that's how God chose to come, to bring his love to us. So can we make room for that today? Let's pray. Jesus, we celebrate you today. Happy birthday. Help us to make room for you and your love in our lives, in our celebrations today, and our time going forward. Help us to make room and know that we are loved by you. Amen.
We who walk in darkness deep now see a light of morning. The mighty God, the Prince of Peace, a child to us is born. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away our sins. Oh, hear our voices crying. Prepare the way, make straight the path. Your King has come to die. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away our sin. Behold the Lamb of God, the life and light of men. Behold the Lamb of God, who died and rose again. Behold the Lamb of God who comes to take away our sin. Who takes away our sin. Behold the Lamb of God, the life and light of man. Behold the Lamb of God, who died and rose again. Behold the Lamb of God, to take away our sin.
Well, now may you go out and enjoy the celebrations of this day, knowing that you are loved by God.